Here's some things that you might not know about your Samsung TV and how to get the best performance out of it. This video, we're gonna talk about it. The first thing you can do with any Samsung TV is you can move the applications on the home screen to customize it. All you wanna do is press the center of the remote control and you'll get this pop-up that says you can move it. In this case, you wanna move your favorite applications to anywhere you want. And once you get done, just hit back on the remote control. So let's say, for example, I want to take YouTube. I can press and hold it, hit move, and then I can move it where I want and let go. You can also go down and hit remove. Once you press on that, it will remove the application from your home screen. Now, if you want to take it a step farther, you want to click on applications and this will load up the App Store. If you go to the very top of the screen, press on the gear, you can see all the applications that are installed on the television. Now and again, you have some options here where you can add them back to that home screen that I just showed you. You can lock the applications or you can move them here and you can reinstall them. But keep in mind, not every app on this television can be removed. The next thing is, how do you find your local channels? So as you know, this TV has what they call Samsung TV Plus. And the interesting thing is, whenever you look through here, you don't see your local channels. So let me show you how to fix that. Go into your settings and then you want to go down to right here where it says broadcast. Make sure you hit auto program with antenna plugged into the television and press start. If you're not sure what to scan, just choose both and wait for the TV to scan for your local channels. Now, once the scan is complete, you can see that your antenna channels now appear here at the top. Another thing I want to point out, if you go to the side, you can go down to where it says edit channels and you'll get a list of all the channels on the television. So you can add your favorite channels and you can remove the ones that you don't want to see just by clicking on them and then going over and pressing delete. That way you can have a custom interface. If you press the 1, 2, 3 on the remote control, you can filter the channels, but if you press up, you can see that's where you're pressing your number pad to go directly to a channel. And I also want to point out that now you get a new icon that says live TV. So if you want to use your local channels, just press on that instead of the Samsung TV Plus. Most Samsung TVs have an internet browser, so if you press on internet, it will load up a web browser. You can use the remote control, as you can see, to move these icons around. And if you want to go up to enter a URL, just press on it, and you will get this keyboard right here. Now, there's a couple of things you can do with this keyboard. First of all, you can type in direct websites like this, or if you press the gear at the bottom, you can then press show editing buttons, hit close, and now as you press in different letters, you'll see a remove button right there, so you don't have to go over to the side to remove that particular letter if you spell it wrong. Now it all depends on your particular country, but you can also change the languages of the keyboard, as you can see right there, so you can find one that works for you. Another thing I want to show you, if you go to the top where it says internet menu, you can see your most visited web pages. You can add bookmarks, as well as go down to desktop view and there's settings. Now inside of these settings, you can see different things like your home page, your preferred search engine, and this one supports Google and Bing. Under privacy and security, this is where you can delete your history just in case you want to delete some type of website that you visited. And again, you can delete cookies and everything right here on the TV. Now, if you have a Samsung smart device where it's connected to your Samsung account, and you can use your Samsung smartphone to unlock websites by giving it access so you can use that phone for that. Now, keep in mind, as you go through these different websites on the television, it will only support certain website and HTML5 files. So if you go to a website and you want to watch videos, that would all depend on the coding of that website. But to me, this is tedious using the remote control that comes with the TV, but it is functional, but there's a better way. You can use your own keyboard and mouse, and most of them comes with a dongle like this that you can plug in the back of the TV on one of the USBs. Plus, this TV supports Bluetooth keyboards and mouse as well, if you want to use that. And in order to use a Bluetooth keyboard and mouse, you will go to your settings, go over here to connections, and then you will go to Bluetooth device list. With your keyboard and mouse in pair mode, it will populate on this list and then you can connect it to the television. But just to give you an example, here's the keyboard, here's the mouse. And as you can see with the mouse, I get a pointer on the screen. I can just press up here. I can then use my keyboard and I can type in any website that I like. There you go. A lot of people ask me, can I play my movie files as well as my music from a thumb drive or a hard drive? So I'm going to show you the options that are available for Samsung TVs. Well, the first thing you notice when I plugged in the SSD drive, it gave me some options, and these are the files that are on the disk. Now, the thing you got to watch out for is that not every file will play on this television. So if you do plug in a drive and you get an error, it's mainly because it doesn't support the particular file that you have. So let me show you an example of what happens if you try to play something that the TV doesn't support. You'll get a pop-up like this, is that the file that you selected is not supported. But if you go into details, it will load up an e-manual, and that's the built-in operating system manual for the TV. And it's going to show us what files are supported on the particular television that you're using. So Samsung gives you these notes right here, so you make sure that you set it up correctly. One of the things that you want to pay attention to is that your drive must be formatted in FAT, XFAT, or NTFS file system just to even play it. Now, it will support subtitles, but it has to be in these particular formats. And for video format, here's where it's very important. So you got to make sure it's an AVI file, MKV, or if you go down here to MP4, those are all supported, but it all depends on how it's formatted. There's also a few other things down here at the bottom. Now, when it comes to pictures, it will support JPEG, PNG, bitmaps, as well as MPO and your Apple formats. But keep in mind, it's not going to support things like TIFF files or things that are not on this list. And here's the different formats it supports for music, like MP3, as well as a few other ones down here at the bottom. But on your television, you can go into the e-manual and you can look through all these different formats to see if it's going to work for you. Now, back on the home screen, I'm going to show you how I got access to it. And this is on one of the newer Tizen operating systems. On the sidebar, when you go down to connected device, you'll get this list of icons. Now, there's two different icons here. The first icon that I got is that when you click on it, it's going to open up a new file directory that it created on the disk. And this is going to be the way Samsung likes everything. So if you drop pictures into your computer, they'll be in there, your music. But if we go back by exiting out of this, it created a second drive right there. And this is the files I previously had loaded on the particular thumb drive. So let's say, for example, if I want to play this particular file here, that's my gradient demo. I can press on it. And as you can see, it's working just fine. But if you ever get an error where it doesn't play, you might have to reformat the file. Some other things to point out is you got your play, pause, you can fast forward, rewind, and if you go over to the side, you have a repeat over there, and we have option that shows the information, and this shows you like all the information off the metadata, off the disk that you're playing. Now, if we go back to your upper folder, there's also a music player in here, so I can press on that, and let's say I want to play whatever file you have in there, you can see there's MP3. Now I can raise the volume and listen to my songs. And again, you still get controls down here. If it's all in the same folder, you can change tracks, do repeat, and a few other features. This is Samsung's SmartThings application, and it's very important if you have a Samsung TV. It does a few things, allow you to control the volume and some of the different functionalities of the television. But for the TVs that don't have Google or Alexa built right into them, this allows you to take the SmartThings application and use the Alexa or Google skill to control the TV through those devices. And this is why it's important. You'll see a thing on the box that says works with Alexa. So how you would do it is basically we go into the Alexa application and then we hit more at the bottom. From there, you want to click on skills and games, and then you want to type in SmartThings. Once you get that, you want to press on enable to use, enter your email address that's connected to your Samsung ecosystem, and go ahead and press on next, put in the password, and then you're going to sign in after you verify everything. There will be some terms and conditions. Make sure you go over everything and hit agree. And now it's going to allow you to authorize your television to work with your Alexa devices that you have connected to your account. And it's really that simple. Now, all the controls are available online, but this is what it looks like if you want to set up the SmartThings to be controlled by your Alexa devices. And you see I have a bunch of them on here on the list. I'll just choose the television that I'm using, the CU7000. I can tell it where I'm going to set it up. Let's say, for example, I choose Office. I can then add it to a group. So whenever I want to turn off that group, this TV will be part of the setup. And let's say, for example, you want to connect it to your Google Home devices. You open up the application, press on Devices, hit the plus at the bottom. You're going to click on Works with Google Home. I'll then need to log into the profile once again, put in the password once again, make sure everything's all verified. You'll authorize the account, and then I would choose the TVs. And now you can see it's on that list of devices. So do your basic features just by using the SmartThings application. Now you can do screen share on a Samsung device. If you slide down twice, move over, they call it Share View. If you click on that, you can see all the different TVs and devices. So I would press on CU7000. And then the TV will pop up if you allow this device. We're going to press that, and then it will start sharing the screen with your smart device. And again, that's how the screen sharing works on this Samsung device. And as you can see earlier, I did add the CU7000. And here's that CU7000 remote. As you can see, all the basic features there. I can slide at the bottom, get the number pad. I have my volumes and channels. And I can go directly to applications, including muting the sound right there, as you can see on the TV itself. So that's another reason you probably want to install the SmartThings application on your television. Another feature most Samsung TVs support is Apple AirPlay. And if I click on it, it'll go into the settings. And on most iPhones, all you need to do is just drag down, press on the dual boxes. It's going to scan the home, and then you can press on CU7000. You will get a number on the screen. Just punch that in, hit OK. And as you can see, everything I'm doing on this iPhone will show on the screen. And keep in mind, this works with Apple computers and iPads as well. So this is how you do Apple AirPlay. And keep in mind, I'm on the exact same Wi-Fi using the exact same frequency, like 5 gigahertz or 2.4. And everything's working fine. It's pretty fluid. And if I want to disconnect, again, I'll just slide down from the top, press on the screen mirroring, and hit stop mirroring. And this may vary. I'm going to show you that it works on this TCL tablet as well, and it could work on your tablet. All you're going to do is just hit cast at the top of it. It's going to search for devices. And again, this may work on your unit as well. Once it goes through, it's going to scan to find all the local TVs. And there's the Samsung CU7000. It's going to ask you to allow it. I'm going to go ahead and hit allow. And there you have it. Now everything you see on the tablet is on the screen, and you can play movies and things like that, but in some cases you might have to leave the screen on. Now for this tip is for the gamers. So let's say, for example, you have your gaming console pulled in, but you want to get the best resolution out of it. The first thing you want to do is go into settings. From settings, go down to connections. Then you want to go down to where it says external device manager. Under here, there's an option for most Samsung TVs, and it's called Input Signal Plus. You want to make sure that the input you're using for your gaming console has a checkbox, otherwise you may not be able to get HDR. So for example, if you look over to the side, it expands your input signal range for external devices, extends your HDR input. Next thing you can do is you can manually go down here and control the black levels, and that'll be up to you if you want to adjust that. And then let's say if we leave it automatic, that's fine. And then you want to go down to where it says gaming mode settings. So right now, set up to automatic. Let's say, for example, you're using your gaming console to play a movie, but you don't want it in game mode. You can go over here and switch it to manually off. The TV will blink, and now it's out of gaming mode. And now when you go back down to your settings, you will have the options for movie, filmmaker's mode, HDR dynamic, or whatever setting you have. You have control over all those different settings just by turning off the gaming mode. And you can manually do that by going into your settings on the main screen, and you can scroll over to where you get to gaming mode, and you can switch it from auto to off right there as well. And one thing to point out here is when it's in gaming mode, you can see that your audio changes along with that. So if you switch it back to off, you now get access to all your sound equalization settings. The last thing I want to show you to make your life a little bit more easier when using Samsung TVs is the remote control. So as you can see, this remote right here is very limited, and you have to use the software to get through some of the functionality. But I'm here to tell you, for $10, you can get this basic remote control. It doesn't have Bluetooth or anything like that, but what it does have is that number pad, and it's gonna be much easier to navigate through the menu system. So you can use this additional to this remote control and save yourself a lot of headache. So I hope this type of video helps you out. I'm Tech Steve. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.